Alright, what's up guys? Thanks for stopping by my channel. Today we're going to be tackling another tutorial in Adobe Premiere. So what we're going to be doing today is looking at what I've found to be the best export settings for Premiere Pro CC 2018. So once you're done cutting up your project, this one for me is a video that I did in Cleveland a couple weeks ago for a skate park around me. I got everything colored, added my titles, everything's all set to export. Once you're ready to move towards the export, what you're going to want to do is click over on File and then drag down to Export over to Media. That'll bring up your Export Settings tabs. Export settings are really important in making sure that your project is kind of seen at its best potential. So not super compressed, but also not too large of a file so that YouTube does its compression thing and does a horrible job at it and ruins your video. So getting your export right is really crucial in making sure your video is seen basically the way that you want it to be seen. So to start off, we'll look at the format. I always export in H.264. You know, you can name your sequence whatever you want. I'll name this one BMX. Make sure you have export video and export audio checked. Obviously, you don't want to export just the video or just the audio, or you're going to end up with just video or just audio once you export. So what we're going to do first is look at the basic video settings. My sequence is 1920 by 900. You just basically have to make sure that your export settings match your sequence settings. If they're different, you could end up with a weird crop or a weird distortion in your video once it's exported. All right, so moving on, we're going to check, make sure you have render maximum depth checked. This takes a little bit longer, but really ups the quality of your export. Moving past that, you want to make sure that you're doing VBR 2-pass. This actually makes the export take twice as long. So if you're in a rush, you can do one pass, but it's going to make your file a lot better once it's exported if you do the 2-pass. Basically, it analyzes every frame twice instead of once, and you end up with a little bit of a better result after the export. I always keep my bit rates at 10 to 12. This is what Adobe Premiere recommends, and I found them to work great that way. And yeah, that's pretty much it. After that, really, you're going to just check use maximum render quality. Again, this makes it take a little bit longer, but to me, I think the extra time is totally worth it. I always want my videos to be seen as, high quality and as true to what I intended them to be as possible. So click use maximum render quality, and that's just about it. Just hit export and wait for your video to be done. All right, guys, thanks for stopping by the channel. If you enjoyed this video, if it helped you out, it'd be awesome if you'd leave a like and stick around for future videos. All right, later.